It was a chilly winter's morning as Thomas arrived back at Farquhar Yard, pulling a long train of stone from the quarry. Percy, a cheeky little tank engine, was there to greet him. "Good morning," Percy smiled. "Good morning," Thomas said. "What are you doing here?" "The Fat Controller has a new engine at the big station, so he has sent me to do the goods work on your branch line." "That's great," Thomas said. "That means I can get back to pulling passengers. You can start by shunting these trucks into the yard." After shunting all of Thomas's trucks, the foreman came over to see Percy. "Duck is bringing a load of salt from the harbour for the station and quarry. It will be winter soon, so we need to grit the paths. Shunt the truck so Toby can come and collect them later." And with that, the foreman left. Duck soon arrived and shunted the train into the siding. Percy was surprised. The trucks had covers over them like roofs on buildings. "Why do those trucks have roofs?" he asked. "These are salt wagons," Duck replied. "They're made specifically for taking salt and to protect it from the rain." "I've never pulled those before," Percy beamed. He was looking forward to shunting them. "They're not deceitful like normal trucks," Duck warned, "but they can sometimes be unstable. Sometimes they rock and salt falls out between the planks and gets lodged in their axles. It makes them much harder to shunt. They're more stubborn than troublesome." "I know almost as much about trucks as Edward," Percy boasted. "They won't be any trouble for me." Later, Duck left with the stone for the docks as Percy started shunting the salt wagons. He buffered up to one and shunted it out of the siding. It went easily at first, but when he tried to pull it, it wouldn't move. Percy pulled harder and harder until the wheels started with a grinding sound, and he shot backwards down the track. The driver applied his brakes and they stopped. The salt wagons just laughed. "Silly things," Percy muttered to himself, and he shunted the wagon into place. He went to collect the other. It moved much more easily. It rocked as he went over the points, but Percy didn't take much notice. Things were going much better. But when he tried to shunt the truck forward, it stuck. Percy pushed as hard as he could, and then suddenly shot forward. His driver was rocked off the footplate and his fireman wasn't quick enough to shut off steam. With a loud crunch, the salt wagon went through the buffers and into the hill. The other wagon laughed, and all Percy could do was sit there in disgrace. It wasn't long before the Fat Controller arrived. "I hear from Duck you were warned about the salt wagons before you started shunting," he started. "However, you don't usually have trouble with trucks, so I shall take this incident with a, pinch of salt. I hope you can learn from this and handle them better next time. Now if you excuse me, I have a meeting with the Road Transportation Board." "Yes, sir, I will, sir," Percy replied. And the Fat Controller left. Thomas helped to clear up the mess while Duck returned to help Percy learn about the salt wagons. By the end of the day, everything was in order and Toby had collected the salt. A warning sign had been put in the siding so the engines knew not to reverse right back to where the buffers should be. "I'm sorry I didn't take your warning more seriously," Percy said to Duck. "It's all right," Duck replied. "We all make mistakes. Besides, we managed to salt it all out anyway, didn't we?" And the two friends laughed, and after another busy day, they shut their eyes for a well-earned rest as the night sky rolled out overhead.